Hello, it's Ilya, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. Today, I will talk a little bit about the book that I'm currently reading and also share with you my TBR for the upcoming readathon, Reading Rush. It will start tomorrow, and this is a readathon that was formerly known as Booktubeathon, and the goal is to read as much as possible during a week, 7 books in a week. And there's different prompts that you can pick books from, and I have tried to do that, but I had to be a bit creative because I don't have all my books with me, so I had to, be a little bit creative. But first, I will talk about the book that I'm currently reading, and this will also be a part of my TBR, because I haven't finished it yet, and that is Cult X by Fuminori Nakamura. And when I talked about it on Tuesday, I said that I was a little bit hesitant because it is described as both transgressive and extreme. And I do think that the main reason why I was a little bit scared was because I was thinking about Chuck Palahniuk. And Chuck and I, we do not get along at all. But I'm glad to say that this is not Palahniuk. It's something completely different, and I am enjoying it immensely. This is a very strange story. It has a lot of characters, and we are following a lot of different characters. But among them, we are following these two cult leaders. One of them is this older man who is the leader of a Buddhist compound. And interspersed in this novel, we have a lot of his lectures, and I'm so fascinated by them because they are really grounded in reality and in science and facts, but at the same time, he is twisting everything to make it fit his own worldview. And I can see how that will like lure people in, because it seems really true and based on facts. But at the same time, it's completely gibberish. So that is one of the aspects that really fascinates me. I also look forward to get to know more of the characters. And we are also introduced to the leader of the Cult X. And he is more like this typical, very dark cult leader. And I see that the chapters about him and that cult is very explicit. One of the chapters was almost like reading porn, and I don't mind that, but I was reading it at a cafe and I almost fell off the chair because it was that explicit. But yeah, I'm looking forward to dive more into this, getting to know more of the characters, learning more about how these two cults are connected, because I do think they are. And it's a really intense and fascinating and very strange story so far. And I do think it will get more explicit and more strange as it moves forward. So yeah, this will also be one of my 7 books for next week. Then to my TBR. I will be reading I Who Have Never Known Men by Jacqueline Harpman. This is a Belgian-French cult classic, and this will fit the prompt that says read a book with 5 or more words in the title, and this has 6. And this is about 40 women who are imprisoned underground, and they do not recall why they are there. They don't remember anything from their past. So that's one. I will also be reading Ponti by Sharlene Teo. This is her debut, so it will fit very well with the prompt read an author's first book. This is set in Singapore, and it's a coming-of-age story. It's about a difficult mother-daughter relationship, and it's also about Asian horror movies. And I love horror movies from Asia, so that's perfect. I will also be reading Curse Words by Charles Soule and Ryan Browne, and this will fit the prompt that says read a book with a non-human character, and Margaret is a koala. For the prompt, read a book with purple on the cover, I will be reading Buffy, The Vampire Slayer by Jordie, Bellaire, Dan Mora, and Raul, Angulo. And this is a horrendous cover, but it's very much purple. And this is a reboot of the original Buffy, and I am super excited because Buffy is one of my top two favorite TV shows of all times. And in this, we meet Buffy. She is 16, she has moved to Sunnydale. She will soon meet both Willow and Xander, but we are not in 1997 anymore. We are in 2018. So it's like a modernized version of the old story. And yeah, I think it will be super cool. I will also be reading White by Marie Darrieussecq. And this is a creative choice because one of the prompts is to read a book that you were meant to read last year, or supposed to read last year. And yeah, I chose this because I have been meaning to read more Marie Darrieussecq for quite a while now. So I will be reading White. This is set in Antarctica. Next week we will have another heat wave, so I think I can need some cold climate to cool me down. And last but not least, there's a prompt that says read a book or a whole book in the same spot. And I have chosen Marguerite Duras, The Garden Square. And I love Marguerite Duras. She is my favorite author, and I try to read at least one book by her every year. And this is about a woman who is sitting in a garden square in Paris, and she meets a man and they start to talk, and that is the premise. I really like the way Marguerite Duras writes. She is very impressionistic, she is very understated, so you need to read a lot between the lines. And in this book, there are mainly dialogue between the man and the woman, and I think that is so Marguerite Duras. I will be reading this in a garden square in Paris. That was my TBR for the reading rush. Are you participating? Please let me know what you'll be reading. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, ha det!